so here's a little rundown of what I got. Got some broccoli, some organic spring mix. These are, what is it, 16 ounce, 1 pounder. I got some mushrooms. Yes, I love cooked mushrooms. Cucumbers. I got, these are the 4 pound wild blueberries. And I actually got these instead of the organic kind because they are wild caught. And these actually have, as you can see here, twice the amount of antioxidants of traditional blueberries. So I typically get the wild blueberries. And like I said, I love that it's the 4 pounder. And these are great for, like, you know, my smoothies. That's primarily what I'm gonna use these for, is for my smoothies. And this is organic chopped kale. Can y'all see that? Organic chopped kale and spinach. And this is another 4 pound bag. I got these again for my smoothies. Same thing with the mango chunks. Frozen mango chunks, another 4 pound. I don't know if y'all can see that. Another 4 pound bag, as you can see. I like these big bulk bags. I feel like you just save a lot more money when you just buy them in bulk like this, especially if you're like me, if you drink a lot of smoothies. I can make like sorbets with these mango chunks, like my little frozen popsicles, like so many things. I was trying to look for frozen raspberries like in bulk, but they didn't have them, but that's okay. But if you'd like to do that, if you like to make smoothies and stuff like that, buy in bulk. I also got some quinoa. Now this will last us a long time. I really have not eaten quinoa a lot. This is a 3 pounder. This will probably last me for about a good 6 months. I'm not even kidding, because I don't really eat quinoa that much. But when I do, like for like stir fries and stuff like that, I do like to use quinoa for that. So that's what I got this for. And I might grind some up as well. I have a coffee grinder, which I use to grind up seeds. So I might also like grind some of these up and use them for like waffles and stuff like that, and make like basically flour out of it. So that's what that's for. I got some almonds. These are a 3 pound bag. I think I've shared this in another video before, but I started buying like my nuts and seeds in big batches as well, just because, again, these are gonna go for almond milk, for salads, like so many different things. So it just saves money to just buy it in bulk. The same thing with the walnuts. I got a 2 pound bag of walnuts because I use them in so many different things. My salads, I've made walnut milk with this, made some veggie burgers with this, like so many different things. Flour, I like to grind these up as well and turn these into a flour that can be used for like pancakes, waffles, things like that. So many different things that you can use this for. But yep, this is gonna last me. This, actually, to be honest with you, these nuts and seeds, these aren't gonna last that long. It seems like a lot, but especially when I'm making things like almond milk and stuff like that, they go pretty quickly. So these I probably have to re-up the next time, or and the next, definitely before the month is over. I also found these. I'm so excited that they have these now. If you're not familiar, I love this brand, but they're not always easy to find. Well, in my area, the Go Raw brand, the organic sprouted pumpkin seeds. These, I think, yeah, they're not cooked, they're just sprouted. And it's got a little bit of sea salt. Pumpkin seeds are excellent, and they're great for snacks, like so many different things, especially if you are a woman who has like hormonal imbalance issues and things like that. These are really good. So like, you can put on snacks, salads, all kinds of stuff. So I was so excited. Hopefully they get some other seeds that they have, some other nuts and seeds from the Go Raw brand, but this is the only thing that I saw from Go Raw, so I'm excited about that. I got some tomatoes because we needed those and they were on sale. And then lastly, I got some organic coconut water. So they had these. I got a 6-pack of the organic coconut water. I've used other brands of coconut water before, but this is one of my favorite brands, the Harmless Harvest. They're a really good brand. Of course, it is organic, fair trade, and all that stuff. So I'm drinking one of the coconut waters.
which is really good, by the way, with a straw. Sorry, I got like my lip gloss and stuff all on the straw. This is a really good deal. Did I mention, I can't remember if I mentioned how much this was, but it was like a six pack for $14 or $13 or $12, something like that. It was in the teens, like lower teens. For a six pack of these Harmless Harvest coconut waters, which I love, by the way. That to me, I don't know how much it costs wherever you guys live, but for to me, that's a good deal, because at my regular local grocery store, like the, what is it? How many ounces is this? Okay, this is 10 ounces. So for like, I think double this or whatever, it's like 10 bucks. But I can get like a six pack for just a few dollars more. Win-win. So if you're not shopping at bulk shop places, like I don't know what you guys have in your area, and I know there's some people that watch me from other countries, but I'm gonna specifically talk about the US because that's all I really kind of know about. But if you have like, I don't know, BJ's, Costco, Sam's Club, whatever the other ones are, you know, like the big box retailers that sell things in bulk, even if you don't have children, I still highly recommend that you shop there just because of stuff like this. Like, you get deals and it prevents you from like going to the store frequently to like get stuff. Like, there are a lot of things that I use, and I use it so much that it just makes sense to buy it in bulk versus having to re-up or keep a bunch of like 8 ounce bottles of this and tiny bottles of that. It's just like, let me just get a bigger size. Let me just get a bigger amount. It'll last me much longer because I use it frequently. So I hope that helped you guys, because I do like to share tips on how to save money on this lifestyle, how to, you know, live, realistically live this lifestyle. And I know a lot of you guys find that helpful, which is kind of why I'm talking right now in this video. I was going to kind of leave it at the grocery haul, but I realized that video, number one, would have been really, really short. And then number two, I don't know if that really would have kind of, I mean, the grocery haul is helpful because you guys see what I buy and, you know, what I eat on a regular basis, and you guys do find that helpful. But I wanted to pop in with a little motivation. I did a poll today on my YouTube channel, my community tab, asking you guys kind of like what you want to see from my channel, because as a creator, I am starting to feel a little bit of burnt out and unmotivated. And one of you guys left a comment basically saying that you wanted some help as far as feeling motivated on your healthy lifestyle, and some tips from me, and how do I get through that, and, you know, just motivation when you're feeling unmotivated. I'm feeling like that too. A lot of you guys might think that, you know, I'm always motivated and I'm, you know, ready to do this and take care of myself and make healthy meals and do all that. There are times and seasons where I don't even feel motivated myself. You know, I love to cook. You guys know that from like following my channel and seeing the recipes that I share. But truth moment, I don't make like elaborate meals, pretty Instagrammable YouTuber meals every single day. There are some days where I'm making the most basic, boring salad. You all don't see that because that looks boring. So I don't always show that, and I'm not going to show you guys. Here's like 5 days worth of boring salads that, you know, I ate. But it's real. You know, there are days where I just whip up something basic that's so healthy. Why? Because I just don't feel like doing all the extras. Obviously, there are times that I do, which is when I share with you guys. But that's not every single day. It's not, you know, reality. We all have lives and other things going on. And I like to try to be as transparent and realistic as possible and let you guys know that when you're feeling unmotivated, you're not alone. You know, like, I think the comment also says something about like PMS or a cycle. Like, I'm a woman too, so, you know, I get it. You know, I go through that moment. I'm going through that season right now. Honestly, I didn't even feel like recording this video. I was like, I kind of just wanted to binge watch on Love is Blind and The Bachelor. But I was like, no, let me get up. Let me do what I gotta do. Share the grocery haul with you guys. Share this little motivation in here. And it's interesting because it's like, whenever I go through moments where I don't feel motivated to do something, when I force myself to just do it, I end up feeling so much better and so relieved and so glad that I ended up doing it anyway. Like right now, like I love talking to you guys. I love helping you guys. So I'm glad that I hit the record button and decided to bring you guys along with me versus, you know, binge watching TV or just doing something that, you know, on the surface level might be kind of unproductive. But I'm glad that I did that. I made a challenge this year to work out and do some sort of movement nearly every single day. And whenever I don't feel like doing that and I push myself to just get up, go to the gym, go for a walk, or, you know, ride my bike, do something, I end up feeling so much better and so grateful that I got up and did that and so proud of myself. So I encourage you to, even when you don't feel like it, get up and do it anyway. But the caveat to that is, if you can't, that's okay too. You know, we all have our moments. And I always say that this isn't about perfection. It's just about progression. Like each day, making healthier, wiser choices for yourself than the day before. And giving yourself grace. I've mentioned that a lot, and it's something that I wholeheartedly believe in, and I have to constantly remind myself of that too, to give myself grace. You know, there are going to be times and seasons where you're not 100%, where you're not your best, and that's okay too. Like, give yourself the grace and give yourself the space to relax. If you want to be lazy for a day and not do anything, that's okay too. Like, I have my days where I don't do anything either, and that's good. It allows my body and my mind to just kind of rest and recuperate for the next day. So I just wanted to kind of share that little tidbit in there. Let me know what you guys want to see on my channel, because I was not joking about creator burnout. It is real. You know, we have our moments as well. So if there's anything that you guys would like to see on my channel, I know y'all are like, recipes. And I do plan on bringing some more recipes when I get my creative energy and creative, you know, juices flowing again. But outside of recipes, is there anything that you guys would like to see on my channel? Are motivational videos like this really helpful for you guys? Just to kind of, or also videos to kind of show like my wellness and healthy lifestyle, like basically like how I live this out. Because I know one of the unique things about my channel is that I am a person with a life outside of YouTube, with, you know, friends, family, obligations, work. I have a regular job outside of, you know, the internet and all of that. And I still manage to maintain my wellness routine, maintain a healthy lifestyle routine. So I would like to share some kind of like behind the scenes about exactly like, not behind the scenes, but like a day in the life. That's it. A day in the life, just kind of how I live and walk this out. Obviously, there's some things that, you know, I won't share on the internet, but whatever I think will be helpful for you guys, leave me a comment and let me know. This was kind of not all over the place, but this is like, I don't even know what I'm going to title this video, y'all. It's going to be motivation / grocery haul. Whatever, but either way, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that you guys found this helpful, from the grocery haul to this little short motivational little inspo that I put in here. But yeah, my goal is always to just motivate you guys to be the healthiest, best version of yourself. So again, if you like this video, give me a big thumbs up. That helps me out on the YouTube algorithm streets. Leave me a comment. Again, let me know your feedback and what you would like to see on this channel going forward. Recipes will be coming back. I am not like abandoning the recipes on my channel. They will be coming back. Don't worry, guys. They will be coming back, because I know you guys really appreciate those. So I'm definitely going to continue to do those. But yeah, thank you so much. If you made it all the way to the end of this video, thank you so much for watching. You know what I was going to say? I was going to say leave a blue heart, because if you know, you know. Me and my friend were having this whole thing about the whole blue heart foolishness. But anyway. Thank you for watching, and I will see you on the next video. Later, sis.